Good morning, everybody. Ask that you find a seat. And want to welcome you here this morning to our Good Friday service presented by the Onoway Regional Ministerial. It's a pleasure to be able to join together on this special weekend. On the Christian calendar marks the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so it is fitting and wonderful to be able to come together in unity as Christian churches throughout this community and remember the events that took place many years ago that are foundational to our faith. And this is a very special occasion, I guess, in other ways, because for the last couple of years we haven't been able to do this. And so it's wonderful to be able to come out and to see each other and face to face. And so we're really grateful for that. These have indeed been difficult years, the last couple of years, and there may be more ahead of us, but we want to just be thankful when we have opportunities such as this. Right off the bat, I want to say apologies on start time. There was some confusion whether it's 10 or 10:30, and for those of you who showed up at 10 o'clock, you got an extra bonus half hour just to be here. But our apologies for some of you who may have been confused about that. As a regional ministerial, one of the things that we support is our local food bank, and so there are a couple of collection baskets at the back, and we would invite you to give towards that. Any proceeds beyond just the rental of this hall are going towards the food bank. And in the springtime here, they are having a bit of a rush on the food baskets, and so they are in need of some food at the food bank. Their shelves are kind of bare. So if you can help out with that, donations can be made at the food bank or at the Alberta Treasury branch here in town. So if you have food items to give, then you can give it those places. The food bank is just kind of beside the Baptist church, and you can bring donations there on Wednesdays from, I think, about 8 or 9 to about 10 o'clock. So please help out with that. They do great work. After our time together, I'll remind you a little bit towards the end, but we can use some help with putting the chairs away. So if you're able to stay on afterwards and give us a hand, it'll go very quickly, but we appreciate some help with that. This is a very solemn part of the weekend that we call the Easter weekend, the week leading up to it, the Holy Week, and then the different events that took place, beginning, I suppose, in the most acute sense with this day, Good Friday, when Jesus was crucified. And because of that, this service is a little bit different than other services. As Christians, we like to celebrate and be glad for all that the Lord has done for us, but it starts with us remembering that Jesus died for us and for our sins. And can you imagine what it would have been like in those days from the crucifixion through to the resurrection? I mean, what an incredible celebration we have when it comes to the resurrection. But for those dark days, they were indeed dark. And so there's a sense today, the lights are dimmed, but there's a sense in which there is a darkness that comes over this day. And so at the end of the service, we encourage you to fellowship, and we don't want to hold you back in that way. But we're not going to turn the lights on and make the place real bright. There'll be a sense of solemnity as we go from here today. So with that, I just want to remind you, if you could please mute your cell phones and just enter into this time. Let me give you a little sense of what's going to take place in these moments that lay before us. We will have a litany of reconciliation and a responsive reading. There'll be explanation on that in a few minutes. And then a number of times for you to join in singing. Dave Block is going to lead in that, and Naomi White on the piano. And then we're going to read the Easter story from the Gospel of Matthew, and we have a number of people that are going to come forward, pastors and church people, to take part in that reading. It's directly out of the Gospel of Matthew in the New International Version. And then there'll be some more singing, and then a special song, which has come to be a tradition, I think. Pat Lavin is going to sing, "Were You There?" And that'll be the end of our service. So with that, let me pray and invite Dave Block to come forward and lead us off in singing. Heavenly Father, we come before you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself as a ransom for all. You tell us, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. This is the day we remember most significantly how you gave your Son to the point of dying on the cross. So, Lord, we invite your presence here this morning. Holy Spirit, come and visit us and remind us of these solemn and significant events. In Jesus' name, amen.
So many things have changed in the last 2,000 years, but a week hasn't changed. The week hasn't changed. We're still just 5 days ago was Palm Sunday, and on the Holy Week, 5 days before, a crowd of people were shouting Hosanna and welcoming Jesus to Jerusalem. We're going to be the crowd, and one of the things we're going to do during the reading is that you're going to follow me in and being the crowd, and the difference between Hosanna and the things that they yelled on the Friday is quite shocking. But we're going to spend some time worshiping and remembering who God is. We're going to start by singing. The words are going to be up on the screen. And we're going to start by singing, "Be Still, My Soul." Let's calm our hearts. We've had a lot of things going on: family, work, traveling, weather, everything in our heads. Let's, as we sing this song, let's remember who we are singing to. And you can stay seated, because this is all about being still, this song. So, "Be Still, My Soul."
Be still, my soul, the Lord is on thy side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to thy God to order and provide. In every change, he faithful will remain. Be still, my soul, thy best, thy heavenly friend. Through thorny ways leads to a joyful end. Be still, my soul, thy God doth undertake to guide the future as he has the past. Mysterious shall be bright at last. Be still, my soul, the waves. still know his voice who ruled them while he dwelt below. Be still my soul, the hour is hastening on, when we shall be shall meet at last.
Amen. The waves and winds still know his voice. Now we have to stand. And we're going to sing, "All Creatures of Our God and King." Lift up your voice and with us sing, "Alleluia." This was written by St. Francis of Assisi. So this is a hymn that the Church of Jesus Christ has been singing for a very long time.
All creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice and with us sing. Softer gleam, oh praise him, oh praise him, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Thou rushing wind that art so strong, ye clouds in sail in heaven along, oh praise him. Rejoice, ye lights of evening, find a voice. Oh, praise him, oh, praise him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Thou flowing water, very clear, make music for thy Lord to hear. Alleluia. So masterful and bright, thou givest man both form and light. Oh, praise him, oh, praise him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. And all ye men of tender heart, forgiving others, God, and on him cast your care. Oh, praise him, oh, praise him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Let all things their Creator bless, and worship him in humbleness. Oh, praise him, oh, alleluia. Praise, praise the Father, praise the Son, and praise the Spirit, three in one. Oh, praise him, oh, praise him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Amen. You may be seated.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Mew Lavin, and I am the representative from the Catholic Church. Now, I have been on the ministerial for 14 years. Seems like. And it has been a true, true blessing. Now we're going to do this litany of reconciliation. Now the following prayers are from Canon White's book, Father Forgive. And some of you may remember Canon Andrew White when he came here in 2018. In November 1940, the Nazis bombed Britain relentlessly, and the city of Coventry was almost obliterated. All that was left of the cathedral were some outside walls, and they are still there today. It was the very Reverend Dick Howard, the provost of Coventry Cathedral, who went into the ruins the next day and wrote on the wall with a piece of burnt wood, "Father, forgive." Not forgive them, but Father, forgive, as we all need forgiveness and reconciliation. We need forgiveness from God. We need forgiveness from our friends and families for the errors of society. And we need to forgive ourselves. The following prayers are a first step in this process of forgiving. The response is, Father, forgive. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. The hate which divides nation from nation, race from race, class from class, Father, forgive. The courteous desires of people, the covetous desires of people, and covetous desires of nations to possess what they do not own.
Father, forgive.
The greed which exploits the work of human hands and lays waste the earth.
Father,
forgive. Our indifference to the plight of the imprisoned, the homeless, the refugee. Father, forgive. The dust which dishonors the bodies of men, women, and children. Father, forgive. The pride which leads us to trust in ourselves and not God. Father, forgive. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ forgave you.
We're invited because we have been forgiven to follow Jesus and be like him and forgive others. We're invited to follow him, to take up our crosses and so this next song is a song of dedication. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Let's, again, you may stay, remain seated as we sing. It's six short verses that talk about the different parts of our lives that we hold on to. Jesus gave everything. Can we give everything to him?
Take take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days at the embrace of Thy love, at the embrace of Thy love.
We're going to sing those words.
Take my feet and let them be swift and beautiful for Thee. Take my voice and let me sing always only for my King, always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from Thee. Take my silver and my gold, not a mite would I withhold, not a mite would I withhold. Take my love, my God, I pour at Thy feet its treasure store. Take myself and I will be ever only all for Thee, ever only all for Thee.
And now let's stand and sing a song of thankfulness for what Jesus has done. As we have responded to Him, we remind ourselves of how much Jesus loved us, how much God the Father loved us to send His Son for us.
Love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that He should give His only Son to make a wretch His treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turns His face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon a cross, my sin upon His shoulders. Ashamed I hear among the scoffers, it was my sin that held Him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished. I will not boast in anything, no gifts, no power, no wisdom, but I will boast in Jesus Christ, His death and resurrection. Why should I gain from His reward? I cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart, His wounds have paid my ransom. Why should I gain from His reward? cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart, his wounds have paid my ransom.
You may be seated, but don't fall asleep because you have a part to play.
Yeah, so that's just a little reminder. When you see up here on the screen, and it'll say crowd, and Dave will lead you guys in the words that come up. But it won't be till towards the end, so you can just relax for a bit.
This is the Good Friday narrative reading. It is a reading from the Gospel of Matthew. While Jesus was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him a large crowd armed with swords and clubs, sent from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them.
The one I kiss is the man, arrest him.
Going at once to Jesus, Judas said,
"Greetings, Rabbi."
And Judas kissed him.
"Friend, do what you came for."
Then the men stepped forward and seized Jesus and arrested him. With that, one of Jesus' companions reached for his sword, drew it out, and struck the servant of the high priest, cutting off his ear.
"Put your sword back in its place. For all who draw the sword will die by the sword. Do you think that I cannot call on my Father, and he will at once put at my disposal more than 12 legions of angels? But how then would the scriptures be fulfilled that say it must happen in this way?"
At that time, Jesus said to the crowd,
"Am I leading a rebellion that you have come out with swords and clubs to capture me? Every day I sat in the temple courts teaching, and you did not arrest me. But this is all taking place that the writings of the prophets might be fulfilled."
Then all the disciples deserted him and fled. Those who had arrested Jesus took him to Caiaphas, the high priest, where the teachers of the law and the elders had assembled. But Peter followed at a distance, right up to the courtyard of the high priest. He entered and sat down with the guards to see the outcome. The chief priests and the whole Sanhedrin were looking for false evidence against Jesus so that they could put him to death. But they could not find any. Though many false witnesses came forward, finally two came forward and declared,
"This fellow said, 'I am able to destroy the temple of God and rebuild it in 3 days.'"
Then the high priest stood up and said to Jesus,
"Are you not going to answer? What is this testimony that these men are bringing against you?"
But Jesus remained silent. The high priest said to him,
"I charge you under oath by the living God. Tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God."
"Yes, it is as you say. But I say to all of you, in the future you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the Mighty One and coming on the clouds of heaven."
Then the high priest tore his clothes and said,
"He has spoken blasphemy. Why do we need any more witnesses? Look, now you have all heard the blasphemy. What do you think?"
"He is worthy of death."
Then they spat in his face and struck him with their fists. Others slapped him and said,
"Prophesy to us, Christ. Who hit you?"
Now Peter was sitting out in the courtyard, and a servant girl came up to him.
You also were with Jesus of Galilee?
But he denied it before them all.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Then he went out to the gateway, and another girl saw him and said to him,
This fellow was with Jesus of Nazareth.
He denied it again with an oath.
I don't know the man.
After a little while, those standing went up to Peter and said,
Surely you are one of them, for your accent gives you away.
Then he began to call down curses upon himself, and he swore at them.
I don't know the man!
Immediately, the rooster crowed, and Peter remembered the words Jesus had spoken.
Before the rooster crows, you will disown me three times.
And he went outside and wept bitterly. Early in the morning, all the chief priests and the elders of the people came to a decision to put Jesus to death. They bound him, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate, the governor. When Judas, who had betrayed him, saw Jesus was condemned, he was seized with remorse and returned the 30 silver coins to the chief priest and the elders.
I have sinned, for I have betrayed innocent blood.
What is that to us? That's your responsibility.
So Judas threw the money into the temple and left. Then he went away and hanged himself. The chief priest picked up the coins and said,
It is against the law to put this into the treasury, since it is blood money.
So they decided to use the money to buy the potter's field as a burial place for foreigners. That is why it has been called the Field of Blood to this day. Then what was spoken by Jeremiah the prophet was fulfilled.
They took the 30 silver coins, the price set on him by the people of Israel, and they used them to buy the potter's field, as the Lord commanded me.
Meanwhile, Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him,
Are you the king of the Jews?
Yes, it is as you say.
When he was accused by the chief priests and elders, he gave no answer. Then Pilate asked him,
Don't you hear their testimony that they are bringing against you?
But Jesus made no reply, not even to a single charge. To the great amazement of the governor, Now it was the governor's custom at the feast to release a prisoner chosen by the crowd. At the time, they had a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when the crowd had gathered, Pilate asked them,
Which one do you want me to release to you, Barabbas or Jesus, who is called the Christ?
For he knew it was out of envy that they had handed Jesus over to him. While Pilate was sitting on the judge's seat, his wife sent him a message.
Don't have anything to do with that innocent man, for I have suffered a great deal today in a dream because of him.
But the chief priests and the elders had persuaded the crowd to ask for Barabbas and to have Jesus executed.
Which of the two do you want me to release to you?
Barabbas.
What shall I do then with Jesus, who is called the Christ?
Crucify him.
Why? What crime has he committed?
But they shouted all the louder,
"Crucify him!"
When Pilate saw he was getting nowhere, but that instead an uproar was starting, he took water and washed his hands in front of the crowd.
"I am innocent of this man's blood. It is your responsibility."
"Let his blood be on us and on our children."
Then he released Barabbas to them. But he had Jesus flogged and handed him over to be crucified. Then the governor's soldiers took Jesus to the praetorium and gathered the whole company of soldiers around him. They stripped him and put him a scarlet robe on him, and then twisted together a crown of thorns and set it on his head. They put a staff in his right hand and knelt in front of him and mocked him.
"Hail, King of the Jews!"
They spit on him and took the staff and struck him on the head again and again. After they had mocked him, they took off the robe and put his own clothes on him. They led him away to crucify him. As they were going out, they met a man from Cyrene called Simon, and they forced him to carry the cross. They came to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. There they offered Jesus wine to drink mixed with gall, but after tasting it, he refused to drink it. When they had crucified him, they divided up his clothes, casting lots. And sitting down, they kept watch over him there. Above his head, they had placed a written charge against him: "This is Jesus, King of the Jews." Two robbers were crucified with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by hurled insults, shaking their heads, saying,
"You who are going to destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. Come down from the cross, if you are the Son of God."
In the same way, the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the elders mocked him.
"He saved others, but he can't save himself. He's the King of Israel. Let him come down now from the cross, and we will believe in him. He trusts God. Let God rescue him now, if he wants him. For he said, 'I am the Son of God.'"
In the same way, the robbers who were crucified with him also heaped insults on him. From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, darkness came over all the land. About the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Eloi! Eloi! Lama sabachthani!"
Which means,
"My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?"
When some of those who were standing heard this, they said,
"He's calling Elijah."
Immediately, one of them ran and got a sponge. He filled it with wine vinegar and put it on a stick and offered it to Jesus to drink. The rest said,
"Now leave him alone. Let's see if Elijah comes to save him."
And when Jesus had cried out again in a loud voice, he gave up his spirit. At that moment, the curtain in the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split. The tombs were broken open, and bodies of many holy people who had died were raised to life. They came out of their tombs. And after Jesus' resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many. When the centurion and those with him who were guarding Jesus saw the earthquake and all that had happened, they were terrified and exclaimed,
"Surely he was the Son of God."
Many women were there, watching at a distance. They had followed Jesus from Galilee to care for his needs. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of Zebedee's sons. As evening approached, there came a rich man from Arimathea called Joseph, who had himself been a disciple of Jesus. Going to Pilate, he asked for Jesus' body, and Pilate ordered that it be given to him. Joseph took the body, wrapped it in a clean linen cloth, and placed it in his own tomb that he had cut out of a rock. He rolled a big stone in front of the entrance and went away. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were sitting opposite the tomb.
And so we wait for Sunday morning with Mary. Let's stand together and sing, "When I Survey the Wondrous Cross."
When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, my richest gain I count but loss, and pour contempt on all my pride. Forbid it, Lord, should boast, save in the death of Christ my God. All the vain things that charm me most, I sacrifice them to his blood. See from his head, his hands, his feet, sorrow and love, loathing, all down. Did e'er such love and sorrow meet, or thorns compose so rich a crown? Were the whole realm of nature mine, that were every far too small. Love so amazing, so divine, demands my soul, my life, my all.
Just stay standing as we declare our hope, who we have our faith in, who do we trust.
Thank you.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, you took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live.
You know what? We're going to skip verse 3. We can't sing it yet. It's not Sunday morning. We're going to skip to verse 4.
No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
You may be seated.
That was a good choice, Dave, but please tell us, give us a little bit of the hint. What happens in that verse?
There in the ground his body lay, light of the world, by darkness slain, then bursting forth
in glorious day.
Up from the grave he rose again.
And as he stands in victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me. For I am his, and he is mine, bought by the precious blood of Christ.
I wouldn't have wanted you to keep that all bottled up for the whole weekend, man. But
that's why we got to wait.
Resurrection Sunday is coming. This is the day, this is the hour when we enter fully into thinking about and pondering the price that was paid by our Savior. And so it is a solemn day. It's a day to reflect. And in great irony, we call it Good Friday. The goodness about it is that our salvation was attained on this day. I want to thank you for joining us here this morning. And once again, invite you to give towards the food bank. If you like, at the back there, there are a couple of baskets. And there's also, you can give food items. Instructions are included on the sheet of paper that was given to you as you came in. I want to encourage you to
continue to ponder these things as we go from this place. If you're able to help us with some of the chairs afterwards, we'd appreciate your help there as well. But a tradition is Pat Lavin leads us in thought by singing, "Were You There?" And invite Mew to come with Pat. And this is just a cappella, and is what we will conclude the service with, just inviting you to consider, were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the cross? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they laid him in the tomb?
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.